Hello and welcome to another episode of Getting Good 0AD. So let's actually do this and get some wood. So we are playing some good old 2v2 on Oasis. So hopefully this will go pretty well. Okay, good. We've got our opening build order sorted. Wait. Oh no, okay, let's actually have you do that. I forgot, I accidentally put everyone on gathering wood, which is not something you want to happen. So let's actually build one of those over there. So it looks like I am the Ptolemies, which is good, I suppose. Okay, looks like he's scouting for something. Alright, so one of you will be building a house, and we'll be helping out with that. And you will be helping out with that. And I'm actually going to transfer you all over there. Because we can really go after the wood over here. So, okay. We still have to get our stuff up a little bit. Okay. We are getting food though. Rush with camels. I could, but I don't really think that's a good idea. I don't know what they have, so actually, let's actually check to see if they have the treasure collected, because I know there is a treasure. No, I want to get my economy up. I don't want to lose everything. They probably have the treasure collected already. Forgot to go look for it. Yeah, looks like it. Yeah, I think it's supposed to be somewhere over here. Anyway, let's get back into the news then. You're going over there. At least we have some area explored. Hey, he's still building that. No, we're going to, yeah, okay, that's a farmstead, good. We're going to build one of those, and we're going to, again, split off the building tasks, not building tasks, the resource gathering tasks, as such, and you will help build that. We're going to see if we can get a boost before we run out of the berries. Alright, let's get more women, since we can. Might as well. Okay, let's actually boost that. Might as well. We're going to need all the wood we can get. So the center bit with the wood is going to be very important. Okay, it might not actually be a good idea to actually go for the berry boost. You'll be doing this. Yeah. I don't actually have any domestic animals on this map as far as I know. So, going for that might not be the best idea. Okay, so let's do that. Let's reassign two of you toward building another house. Let's build it over here. Because why not? And once you're clear of that area, let's grab five of you. Build an additional farm, additional field. And boost that as well. And let's build another field. And we'll have to wait till the house is complete before we can continue expanding stuff, but hopefully stuff will be going well by then. Alright, You go collect that as well. Okay. You're actually about to complete that, so we're going to build another one as well. And thereafter, another one. Because why not? Okay, we can attack now. As long as they haven't decided a rush strategy, we should be fine. Okay, so these next five that actually come out, we're going to task them on gathering wood. And then we can potentially task a soldier to... Don't tell me their pathing is going to get messed up, because that would be a mess. Alright. Need one more structure. That's probably going to be a house, as far as I know. Yeah. So once one of these is complete, we can move on from there. And then we'll start building lots of infantry. So hopefully that will work. Get out of there. Yeah, this is a fair investment. We have the resources, so why not? Alright, there we go. Let's go through that. Is this worthwhile? Not really. We have a wide front here, so... Maybe building a palisade at a later point would be worthwhile. But in the meantime, let's actually build another house, because we know that we'll eventually run out. Okay. Let's build some guys. Some geish. These actually cost metal, so I don't really want to build them right now at the top of it. But actually, screw it. Let's do it. Can't be too much more expensive. Oh, what are you doing? You're going to go and get us some resources out there. Also helps with the scouting. So once you're done with that, we're going to actually transfer you to the farm, since there's plenty of room on the farm for y'all. And hopefully after that, things will be fine, because these guys can build all of the other buildings. For example, you two will actually get transferred to building this. And you three will get transferred to building something there. And in the meantime, we're actually going to get some more guys up as well. Just get the constant building going.
Yeah, Steve.
So you will be doing that.
Yeah, Steve.
And you will be helping with that. There you go. Hopefully I'm not behind on anything. So once this is done, actually we can already split off and build another house, since we are actually running low on population again. Surprisingly. Okay. We don't have the resources to build more than 5 archers at the moment, so we're just going to build more pikemen.
Yes,
2 guys will help with that.
Yes,
you will gather wood. Yes, and in exchange, one of you will help with that. There you go. So that at least we have a woman boosting the guys over here when they're getting the stone.
ESD?
You will also gather wood, while you will go there. Okay, trade wood. Now close. Diplomacy. Tribute 100 wood. There you go. I've been attacked. Fair enough. Wait, is he doing a rush strategy? I don't know what...
ESD?
Rust Bolivar!
Alright.
ESD?
So,
ESD?
Okay, this is producing. We can actually switch to producing from here. This actually costs stuff. So let's actually get skirmishers instead of that.
ESD.
In the meantime, we're going to build one of these.
ESD.
As well as another one of these.
ESD.
You guys can go there. Two of you. And two more of you will go there.
ESD.
And one of you will go there. But actually,
ESD.
I'm going to transfer some of you up here. Okay, so this is going to finish sometime soon. Transfer up. Wow, this guy next to me is pretty good at this, actually.
Yeah, see?
Transfer up. Okay. We should be getting some guys coming out pretty soon. And let's get more guys coming out as well. So actually, we need more wood. We need more stone as well. And more metal. There you go. Oh, these guys are fast. Since you're fast, let's get two of them on there.
ESD.
Two of them on there.
ESD.
And another guy on there.
ESD.
And in the meantime, military colony. This is Ptolemaic. Is weaker and carries smaller territory, but is cheaper and built faster. Trained settler soldiers, various nationalities. It's a good pop bonus. Could build it here and then use this as a fortified advanced base.
Yeah, see?
But actually build one of these as well. But building it over here would probably be a better idea.
ESD?
But actually, let's all build this real quick. And then I'll have you all go out and do some other stuff. Okay, this won't take too long to complete. In the meantime, man, this one thing I always want it, but I never have it. There you go. Okay, building it. Nice work, guys. Nice work. And this will allow us to actually fortify our wood gathering area. This is good because it means that we can actually go deeper into this region. Hopefully this isn't a big misplay, because this has taken quite a few resources and quite a bit of time.
BSD?
So I'm actually going to send you all to do that. What's this? Gallic Mercenary Swordsman. Wow. It's a bit expensive though, so probably not my first choice. These guys. Macedonian. Egyptian women. They're fine. Alright. So we're getting plenty of stone, not as much metal, but fair enough. We can't really afford that, let's be honest. It's not in the budget. Dave Ramsey says it's not in the budget, so let's actually boost metal production then, since we're going to be using lots of metal, so we'll actually have three of you on metal, and stone is fine for now, so we're actually going to be... temple? Yes, please, let's do that. Oh my goodness! What have I done? Go build a house. There you go. Send you out there. Hopefully I'm going to be able to build a fortress over here, because that would be a... Actually build it, mates. Don't just have one guy building it and five guys sitting around. On second thought, I just noticed that you were probably from more guys that came out of the building. So I'm actually going to transfer you to do that. And in fact, let's get this going. And we should probably get more guys going as well. So two more buildings needed. This is one of them. So the other one, we can build a market. And is there another unique building that maybe might be needed? Doesn't look like it. Okay, so this is going to be finished. They're going to move on to building that. And we've got a massive amount of food. A mahoosive amount of food, as some might say. And our pop cap has gone up. So, it's probably a more expensive unit. Mercenaries, as I'd expect. Just keep building at mateys. Okay. In the meantime, what am I actually going to base my army off of? Big question. Okay. Let's get some guys up. Why not? Who doesn't want some guys? Some guys? There you go. You go with that. Okay, so now, there we go, let's just do that. Might as well, in the meantime, we can build one of these. Sounds fair enough. This is expensive, we're not going to do that. We are going to build one of these pretty soon, once this stuff, okay. Looks like we still have plenty of resources with which to build. Gatherwood mateys, Gatherwood! Still expensive, I think. Now, if something only costs food, then... Actually, this only costs food, so let's do that. And this... actually a lot of stuff. Plus 8 range, Healing rate. Let's do healing rate. Okay.
Let's boot that move.
And once that finishes, we're going to be building this.
Yeah, no.
Send everyone in. And what is this actually? That's actually pretty good. And it doesn't cost too much. Might be worthwhile. Okay, well, this is the point of a game in which I should probably be starting to build up an army. Problem is, I'm not entirely sure what I want my army to be made of. So, let's get more Gallic mercenaries, eh? Okay. Maybe cavalry might not be the worst idea, so let's actually spend some food on that. And get cartography. Getting lots of wood now. Massive amounts of wood, in fact.
Yeah, Steve.
Since you're out early, you might as well help. Actually, you guys can go build this over here. Don't want it to be too close to the front lines. It's 2,000. Alright, let's see what the map has in hold for us. Okay, actually killed a bunch of these guys with a Phoenician trireme. Phoenician trireme. Oh my goodness! Looks like there is such a thing as a cavalry rush. I feel rather useless this game, but I will be seeing you all next time. Okay, hello. Looks like my ally is actually... What is this? Double default arrows. Oh yeah, matey. Yeah. How about... What do we do now? Well, if we're winning, I might as well, build one of these, eh? Let's expand a bit. Who are these? Libyan. Spaldaka, apparently. Okay, Espeldaka has been defeated. So let's actually take a look at some of this stuff. Let's help out. Let's actually take a look. Okay, so this Nigel 87 actually... My goodness, this... I might actually have to release this in one video rather than two. I was originally planning to release this as two videos, but looks like I actually had some professional early rush master guy. And he actually He beat one guy and intimidated the other one into losing. But let's actually take a look at what his stuff looks like. Okay. Let's capture that, eh? while I was just busy trying to slowly push a front, you know, getting sustainability up, he was just rush it, man. I mean, look at this. He was pretty good with his economy. He had so many people just doing stuff. And, so he was Persia, apparently. And, my goodness. Didn't even bother with Marketplace. Just by the time I actually got my cartography up, we already had it in the bag, my goodness. I have to learn from this guy. This was amazing. Okay, so he's actually offline now. So now that we've done that, let's just conquer everything else on the map. Alright. Let's just do that, just for the sake of padding, that's right. We're going to extend the time, we're going to conquer everything, because why not? Send everyone in. Okay. The low infantry have arrived. What are the actual hero units? Ptolemy Soter, okay, fair enough. Cleopatra, understandable. Philopator, I actually don't know that much about the in-between Ptolemies. I only know really about the first and the last one. Okay. So we actually can't do anything anymore. Man, this is actually... Maybe if I... I know what to do. What I do is grab these guys. Attack nearby. I can't actually change their mode, so if they can't... Okay. Going to take this, mateys. We're going to take this. That's right, mateys. MLG. Not really. Let's be honest. It's not MLG at all. These things will slowly start falling to me. That's fine. So now we're going to just push with everything we've got. Send some guys to take care of that. Okay, this is actually falling rather quickly compared to the other one. I don't know why this one took so long to fall and this one's pretty fast. Don't actually know. Kill him. There we go. Kill him! Okay, so the death animation is pretty obvious. The guy and the animals die, but the chariots just lie around. Yeah, that makes complete sense, actually. Okay, so now everything slowly gets converted. And we have achieved a victory of sorts. There we go. Just kill everyone. There we go. And that falls. Why does it fall? Don't actually know. Oh, he was trying to take it back. That's interesting. Okay. Okay, well, I think that's enough, actually. I think we've done plenty, so let's actually resign is grayed out, so I suppose I exit. Yes. Okay. let's actually take a look at the stats. Economically, my goodness. Did better than the other guys, but they were being attacked, so that sort of makes sense. Military score. I never actually got to engage the enemy, so this is heavily biased on the fact that I never actually got to engage the enemy, which is why it's so tiny. Exploration, total score, buildings. Yeah, I actually built more stuff because I was trying to play the long game when he was trying to play the short game. So he was a rusher, I was more of a long game player. So actually that combines pretty well, because if his attack strategy would have failed, then it would have been easy for him to fall back on me, because then I would have been able to come in afterwards. Spadalka built some stuff. Diniarco was definitely the carry on that team. Units. Didn't actually build as many as he did because I wasn't rushing. But yeah, a lot of what he built was lots of cavalry. He was trying... Yeah, that's what he was telling me early. He wanted me to cavalry rush, but I didn't think it was the safest strategy, so I didn't do it. Food. Wood. Okay. Stone and metal. Okay, so he didn't really bother getting to the last phase, looks like. Loot. Got some loot, but a lot of that was probably endgame. Spadalka, actually pretty good at getting food, but doesn't really matter in the end, though. Market? No market activity at all. I was actually looking forward to some of that, but it just didn't pan out because the game was too short. Vegetarian ratio. Not surprising. Feminization. My goodness. His was just basically women and cavalry. That's basically what it looks like to me. KD. My goodness, that's a terrible KD. But that's probably really weirded out because I didn't actually engage the enemy that much. Map exploration. Okay, fair enough. Map control. Yeah, I was more of a long-term map control kind of player, so I was building fortress and civic center after the other, trying to get things done. So thank you all for watching. If you have any comment of any kind, really, just feel free to post it. Advice is always appreciated. And if there's anything else you've got to say, just say it. And thank you all for watching. You can follow me on, subscribe on YouTube, follow me on Twitter and Google Plus if you really want to. Donate on Patreon if you want to see more. And that's it. Thank you all for watching, and I will be seeing you all next time on Awiltos. Over and out.